General, you mentioned about the use of body cameras. How is that going along?
Yes. Well, actually, almost 3,000 cameras have been distributed to the around 171 units, particularly the city police station. But none of them, the personnel on these units, have been trained already. But for those units which personnel have been trained already, so probably by next week or the few weeks to come, mag-start na tayo ng aming operation. We will not wait for the, of course, we have coordinated with the Supreme Court on their intention to provide protocols. But yun naman po, meron din kami sariling protocol. So for those police units na na-issuehan na ng mga body cam at na-train na yung mga personnel na yun, very soon, isisimulan na po natin yung paggamit ng body camera sa kanila.
General, what is your timeline and what is your goal that all police officers should be given body cameras?
Well, it depends on the availability of body cam. You see, Mike, itong body cam na ito, hindi yung basta body cam lang na nabibili natin na camera na makapag-record. Ito kasi, andito kasi, package kasi ito, and it have undergone the meticulous process of procurement. At ito kasi, ano siya, yung integrity. It couldn't be tampered, hindi pwedeng baguhin operation ito, may nire-record. All of these things have been considered, kaya nga medyo natagalan siya. So right now, and I believe that we have been lobbying for the for our lawmakers for the funds for additional procurement of our body camera. So yung kumpleto na kailangan natin is around 34,000 units. But the 3,000 units which have been procured and distributed, ayan po naman ay naandun na sa mga ating mga city police station. So kung madadagdagan yan para sa ating municipal police station, napakaganda po yan. But naniniwala ako na hindi man ma-one count yan, pero additional units will be given to us, ay napakalaking bagay po yan para sa ating operation. Not only for the suspects but also for the police na pwede nagkakaroon ng unfounded allegations.
General, you mentioned 34,000 body cameras. How much budget are we talking about? How much is already available to the PNP? How much is lacking?
Well, I don't have the exact figure, but right now we have given the 3,000. But I have seen the lawmakers that we have talked to, both from the House of Representatives and Senate, and some of them, ando po yung willingness na maghanap ng pondo para po madagdagan pa itong body camera para sa ating kapulisan.
General, some groups, rights groups, activists have called on the Supreme Court and even the PNP to revise the rules on the issuance and implementation of search and arrest warrants. Do you support these calls?
Well, you know, it's up to them. Guidelines, kanya-kanyang trabaho tayo. Eh, hindi namin trabaho na maggawa ng guidelines. For us, we'll just follow what are the protocols that have been issued by the competent authority. So walang problema sa amin niya, Mike. In fact, when we were asked by the Honorable Justices of the Supreme Court on comment on the use of body cam, kami po nagsabi sa kanila na since limited lang itong mga cameras na ito, na inisyu lang sa mga city police stations, so ang aming suggestion po, at least for the service or implementation of search warrant, magamit ito ng ating mga operatiba.
General, let's go to the incident involving the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency and the Philippine National Police. The NBI said an Occidental Mindoro inmate was dictating the tempo of the drug operation. Are you investigating this and what have you uncovered so far?
Well, I've been coordinating actually with the Bureau of Corrections even when I was in NCRPO. And recently, with our former Chief PNP, General De Bolsinas, we have a very close coordination with them. And yun naman, hindi na bago yun, di ba? Kahit nung una pa na sinasabi nga, yung mga mastermind of all these illegal activities, not only for illegal drugs, but also in kidnapping and other, heinous crime, naandun pa rin. Yun nga po yung binabago ng ating sistema, even ng Bureau of Corrections. And isang angulo na ating tinitingnan. At nakakalungkot nga na because of that, it resulted in on misencounter. Ito yun yung, ito yung nire-repaso ng ating Senado. And not only the other day that the PNP has attended the Senate hearing. Unfortunately, I was not able to attend to that hearing. But yesterday, I attended the Senate hearing presided by Senator Bato de la Rosa. And ang pinag-usapan nandun is kung paano ma-improve yung ating operation. Kasi dati na lang, lagi sinasabi na eh bakit na nahuli nyo? Puro mga small time na, yung mga big time din nahuli. Kasi nga, eh yung batas na nandito ngayon is, well, napakadaling palusutan ng mga big time syndicates as well as high value targets itong mga itong ating operation ito. Kaya nga nire-review nila na ito ay mapalakas but not sacrificing of course the integrity at hindi dapat abusuhin. Kaya may mga safeguard na ina-address yun. So with regard to that information, eh we believe na talagang nangyayari yun at pwedeng mangyari. That's why we have to address that with the closer coordination, not only with the Bucor, but of course with the law enforcers, particularly the PNP and the PDEA.
General, what is the PNP policy when it comes to the use of detainees in drug operations? Can you actually resort to bringing detainees out of detention to participate in a drug operation?
Because no, that is not allowed. Yes, Mike, that is not allowed. That's why investigation is being conducted. And well, we have given directive reminding our personnel, if you want information, you can get information. But you know, you cannot. You need the court order or a permission from the court if you want to bring out any detainee under your detention or custody.
General, if I may point out, this practice was already exposed in February during the misencounter in Quezon City. And yet, supposedly, it happened again last week in a near misencounter. So in the time being, what actions were taken by the PNP to ensure that this does not happen again?
First, investigation is being conducted. And second, we have given reminders and directive to our personnel on the ground to remind them na talagang hindi allowed yan. So we have to conduct efficient investigation. And these things that are, you know, in violation of the protocols, policies, and laws should not be resorted to by our police investigators.
Lastly, General, what are your thoughts on House Bill 7814? It's a bill that seeks to strengthen the Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Act. But under that bill, a person present in the immediate vicinity of an area of distribution or sale of illegal drugs is presumed to have been involved in such activities unless proven otherwise. Doesn't this contradict or reverse the presumption of innocence, General?
Well, actually, Mike, yan nga yung mainit na contentious issue. Pero yun nga sinasabi natin na for so long a time, sinasabi nyo, bakit hindi natin mahuli yung malalaki na yan? Kasi nga, napakadali for them. Wala naman sila in possession kahit nasa paligid sila. So these are the things na nakita, no less than by Senator Bato de Lorza, who was our chief PNP then. Pero yung presumption ito ngayon, kaakibat niyan is yung sigurado na hindi siya abusuhin. On the same manner, with regard to the police officer, andyan din yung presumption pa rin na pag nalaglag ang kaso mo, talagang binanggal mo yan. At responsible din kami doon sa pagkakataon na yun. So it is not only yung presumption na ito is given to the suspect but also to the police kung kami naman, on the other hand, is merong lapses on this thing. So, alam mo, it needs to be, you know, to be discussed, and all the sectors of the society, which are stakeholders in this, have been invited, even the Commission on Human Rights. At as para sa amin, of course, we belong to the law enforcement, and as long as meron tayong safeguard para hindi abusuhin yan, kaya po sila mababatas, di ba? So kung ipasa nila yan, napakaganda for us, but nandito naman kami to implement just in case and to see to it na hindi ito aabusuhin.
All right, General, thank you so much for a fruitful discussion this morning. We hope to have you on again. Thank you, PNP Chief General Guillermo Eleazar. Good morning, sir.
Thank you, Mike, for having me. Good morning.